Let's talk about the Teledyne Continental Motors Armored Gun System. In this video, we will compare it to an already available tank in the US tech tree and try to find a conclusion on whether or not it's worth for you to keep or buy it on the marketplace. This is Dog Tactics for you, enjoy the video. But first, let's talk about the vehicle's history. The TCM AGS was Teledyne Continental Motors' entry for the Armored Gun System competition of the US government. After the Vietnam War, the government realized that they need a better airdroppable platform than the M551 Sheridan. So in 1982, the company started to design a new vehicle. The engine was borrowed from an M2 Bradley and moved together with its transmission to the front of the vehicle. It got placed on the right-hand side, while the driver was placed on the left-hand side, right next to it. With a battle-ready weight of just around 20 tons, it turned out to be quite fast. In tests on a highway, it was capable of a top speed around 80 km per hour or 50 miles per hour. The Mendes turret was especially designed to achieve a decrease of weight and increase in survivability for the crew. It was fitted with the British 105mm rifled L7 gun that got significant upgrades, including a muzzle brake. There were even mentions of an upgunned version with a 120mm smoothbore gun, but it was never to be realized. Additionally, it received night vision and thermal imaging, paired with a two-plane stabilizer and an autoloader capable of holding up to 9 rounds and an armor rack for 29 rounds. Testing proved that 10 shots per minute were quite possible. The first prototype was shown to the customer in 1985, but sadly was never developed any further, since it lost the competition in favor of a vehicle that should later become the M8, which got ditched as well for financial reasons later on. So there's that. Now, with the history out of the way, we can now focus on the TCM's stats and compare them with a similar light tank, the M1128 Striker. On the left side we see the stats for the TCM, on the right side those of the Striker. As it is right now, the TCM is sitting at a battle rating of 9.3, while the Striker is sitting at 9.7. Both vehicles share almost exact the same turret. So it's no wonder that they have the same rotation speed. With an unskilled crew, you get a rotation speed of 23.8 degrees per second, while with a skilled crew and modified vehicle, you can get up to 40 degrees per second. While both of them share quite some features, like night vision, the laser rangefinder, and thermal sights, the autoloader is a different story. Both hold 8 rounds ready to go, but the TCM is slightly faster and just needs 5 seconds to reload, while the Striker needs 7.5. This time doesn't go down with crew skills. The next big difference comes in the armor of the vehicles. The Striker is equipped with 12mm of steel all around the vehicle, while the TCM takes that value and doubles it on almost every front. Except for the front of the vehicle, there it is tripled. Although, to be fair, the Striker gets the Maxus 2C added armor that is supposed to catch most explosive rounds. Even though the TCM has a better weight to power ratio in 22.8 HP per ton, in contrast to the Striker's 15 HP per ton, the Striker reaches a higher top speed of 121 km per hour, while the TCM goes by 72 km per hour. The reason for that is quite obvious. While the TCM is a track vehicle, the Striker is a wheeled one, which means that the TCM is a lot beefier and slower vehicle than the Striker is, with essentially the same firepower. Let's talk about the modifications real quick. I will just go over the upgrades that I deem most important. Gear 1. While both of them get access to APDSFS rounds here, it's important to note that the Striker gets thermals way faster than the TCM. In Tier 2, nothing too special happens. The TCM has exclusive access to hash rounds here. If the Striker won Tier 1 and a TCM wins Tier 3, it gets earlier access to the rangefinder, even though its thermals come in late. Tier 4 gives the Striker an edge by giving its rangefinder and then vastly superior APDSFS round. While some of the things seem minor, The Striker has another big advantage. For reaching each subsequent tier, you just need 2 upgrades, while the TCM needs 3. Making the stock grind of the Striker a lot easier in comparison. The TCM's role is to stay in the back and use the turret to take shots from cover. The manless turret helps to survive enemy fire and gives you a low and small profile. So it's not suitable if you like to press W to win. In all the games I've played, I've never even once got armor wrecked. So don't worry about taking more than 8 rounds to the battlefield. As long as you can cover your back. Let's talk about the protection. I will show both light tanks next to each other, since they are built quite similar. For this test, I used APDS FS rounds. In this scenario, we face the tank up front. Shooting the left side where the engine is housed proved widely ineffective, since most of the times only the commander died, leaving the vehicle capable of returning fire. On the other hand, a shot at the right side of the target most often gets rid of the gunner and the driver. In contrast, a shot from behind, especially a center shot, will in most cases destroy the tank, so watch your back carefully. I might add that shooting the turret might destroy its breech, but doesn't damage the rest of the tank too much. So in terms of armor and protection, both of them are really similar. While the TCM gets more raw thickness, the Striker has spaced armor that helps to diminish the effectiveness of shrapnel. So let's come to a conclusion. After we have compared those two fairly similar vehicles, we have to ask the question if it's worth to get the TCM AGS or just to aim for the Striker. In my opinion, if you like the playstyle of the AGS that consists of using your surroundings as cover and shoot enemies from afar, the TCM outperforms the Striker. While the Striker can do the same job, the TCM would be more effective because of its smaller silhouette. The added armor of the Striker won't save you if you come face to face with a Leopard 2 or similar. But from a great distance, the armor does a good job at protecting the crew. As I was testing the TCM, I never even once died because my rounds exploded on me, and I took quite a few hits from the distance. If you prefer to get quickly into position and wait for the enemy to fall into your trap, then you can confidently say that the Striker is the better fit for you. The TCM thrives in terrain with a lot of hills and cover, while the Striker is a little bit more versatile and tries to outpace the enemy. The TCM might be good for more experienced players, but it's still a fun and capable tank. It fills its niche pretty nicely, and I would definitely recommend it. If you enjoyed my video, leave a like, comment, or subscribe to my channel to help me grow. In case you want to catch me live, follow me on Twitch. Link is in the description. Thanks for watching.